Hello there, and welcome back to Kitchen Table Talk with Lolo. This is yours truly, Lolo. In this segment, we are going to talk about the island of Exuma, Bahamas, one of the 700 islands and 29, or should I say 30, prominently inhabited islands. 29, one of the 29 other family islands, the old islands that you can go to and visit for peace of mind instead of going into Nassau, Bahamas, where the propaganda had taken over, talking about crimes and safety and all that stuff. You guys are safe, trust me. Well, Exuma, let's talk about Exuma. Okay. Exuma consists of Little Exuma and Great Exuma, the larger island. A part of the one large island that's kind of cut in half. Over 100 years or more, hurricanes has been beating on these islands. The wave, the current has been running, hitting these islands, and one, two, or three of the islands have been kind of cut in half. We have North Andres, South Andres. We have the mangroves that give, you know, the breeze blows through. It's kind of not separating, but it's still one Andres. Abaco, the same thing. And Exuma is kind of similar to it. Okay, Exuma is particularly quiet, very quiet, particularly quiet, and connected by a small bridge to Great Exuma. The bridge is famous with locals for great fishing, while Little Exuma undoubtedly boasts the best beaches on the planet. Really, you gotta see them. The population of the island is listed around 7,300. It is remarkably safe with essentially zero crime. It is one of those places where everyone knows everybody. Small community, tight-knit community, okay? There's a number of activities vacationers can enjoy while on vacation in the Exumas. Whether you want to find a beach with no one around, go on a tour for deep sea fishing. You can go on an excursion for bone fishing. Take a tour on the island or to see the famous swimming pigs or swim with the sharks, swim with the stingrays, feed them. Swim with the turtles, feed them. There are activities for the whole family. There is also beaches that are famous for starfish. $9, and how could I fail to mention caves that you can tour and you can explore like a whole day. Oh, let's not forget the many small islands and keys for overnight camping after a successful all-day fishing trip. Now, I know you'll be thinking about some of those things, but there are many people who believe in overnight camping. You can go fish on the bonfire, one of the key on the keys, on the smaller islands. Just don't go to Johnny Depp's island, Chris Angel's island, or Beyonce's island, or one of those other islands. They are privately owned islands, but it'd be posted. And if it's not posted, the folks not there are down the beach, clean up after yourself. The beach and water, exploring life is fully alive. The beaches and the water, when I say the waters, because there are blue holes, ocean holes, where you can swim. For exploring wildlife, the beautiful, colorful life of the underwater reefs, according to Jacques Rousseau, his most favorite place in the world to dive, second largest barrier reef in the world, located in the Bahamas. Access to renting boats and beach equipment are readily available. On the other hand, of the 10 to 12 casinos in the Bahamas, remember this, none of them are located on the island of Great or Little. I mean, tranquility. You can just chill, relax. They know a bunch of the tourists who are coming in, they're like you, they want a kayak, they want a skiff, they want a banana boat, a sea sport ride, they want a parasail. They want to do these type of things. They want to snorkel. They want to dive. Places. Stay in Exuma. Breezes Resorts. The Island House. Micah's Resort, Grand Isles Resorts and Residence, Sandals, Emerald Bay, must I say, at its work for its own beauty. Hideaway at Palms Bay, Exuma Point Village Swimming with the Peaks Resorts. Yes, Swimming with the Peaks Resort. The Ocean Club, a Four Seasons Resort. Very classic. Cape Santa Maria Resort, Prophet's Beach House. There are many, many more. Okay. The places to stay in Exuma while on Exuma are abundantly available, but booking in advance is the best way to go about finding the right place or right places for you and your family and friends to feel comfortable home away from home. I can't begin to tell you about the food and all that good stuff and all that. As you know, the food is right now going a revolutionary update, I should say. I like my words, you know, evolving in the Bahamas. In about 50, 60 years, our population today is around 400,000, with approximately 80 to 100,000 undocumented immigrants, most of the 80 in the Bahamas, maintain their culture. They stick together because, of course, unlike the United States, Jamaica and other places, there are no thousands of residency and citizenship being given to people who are coming in the country illegally like that. So they stay in their groups in the areas and they cook the foods and in many cases, Bahamians support them. And so the food has that French Bahamian or Patois Bahamian taste. Okay. It's exquisite. What can I say? Nowadays the Bahamian has something new to offer, even coming from illegal immigration, evolution of foods. Beaches to visit in Exuma. I'm gonna get back to the restaurants. Exuma Point Beach, Cocoa Plum Beach, Farmers Hill Beach, Three Sisters Beach, Tarby Beach, Jolly Hall Beach, Pretty Molly Beach, Forbes Hill Beach, Starfish Beach, Chat and Chill Beach, where the Chat and Chill restaurant is, food on the beach as well. Right there, Bahamian food, culture, sunshine, sea, and food. What else could you ask for? And accommodations. Dollar Beach, Red Shark Key, Manawar Key, Staniel Key, Pig Beach, Compass Key, the Sandbar, Rubber Key, the Musician's Mermaid Dive Site. You can just go down and play the piano, take some pictures, take a few divers and hang out and whatnot. I want to go back and touch on the Thunderball Grotto. Thunderball Grotto is where James Bond movies filmed. Several other movies were filmed in this area using this specific site. So you can go and explore, take pictures, and go back and watch your movies and say, there, I swam right there where Ian Fleming swam. You will love it. Now, guys, let's talk a little more about places to explore. Lazy River, Marsh Harbor Sandbar. These sandbars, you can walk for hundreds of yards, man, on just the sand, and you're in the ocean area. And of course, periodically, you'll find some treasures, some beautiful sea treasures that are worthy. You know, Olike Bay, Starfish Beach, Manawa Key. These places are these places these places are places to really visit. That's why I'm kind of hampering on it. Okay, places to eat, restaurants. Again, let's get back to the food. Blue Underwater, Chat and Chill. Among many other places to eat, there are high-end to inexpensive to low-expensive food places to dine and eat locally and in the resorts. Let me tell you something. Exuma is all that and a piece of work. Hopefully, in another video later on down, I will share photos with you about this beautiful island or beautiful islands. I believe there's some 23 islands comprised of the Exuma Islands. things to do. You can rent a speedboat. You can rent a speedboat and go to the island, peak of islands or island of peaks. You can swim with the pigs, feed them. Swim with the sharks, feed those, the nurse sharks. Feed the stingrays, swim with them. Feed the iguanas. You go to the iguana island, you go to a private beach, feed the iguanas, they run up to you. It gives you that ancient feel, you know, like they say before the Big Bang. You can swim with the turtles, you can feed the turtles. The turtles may give you a little nip, but other than that, it's a vacation. Building memories. That's what vacations are for. Tropic of Cancer Beach, which is located on Little Exuma, and the Cocoa Plum Beach, which is located on Great Exuma. These places you can walk for a mile or so. Just sandy beach and more times than one. Though we have some 8 to 10 million tourists visiting yearly, 700 islands, approximately 2,000 keys. Many of our tourists or visitors, they actually sail in on speedboats coming in from Florida area. They come in, some of them live in the yachts. Some of them yacht over. And those who are flying over, not all of them are beachgoers. But you can find places that you can explore and enjoy all to yourself for miles, hours, and days on end in the 29 additional islands, other than vacationing on the island of New Providence. Of course, there's a straw market and many other places. Now let's talk about how to get there. You can get to the island of Exuma by ship, cruise ship. You can get there by excursion boats coming in from Florida and other parts of, and from Nassau to different islands. Or you can take a boat, the mail boat. The mail boat is just as important to the Bahamas as freight trains are to the United States. So now you have the freight trains, but you have the trains that also carry passengers. We have boats that carry passengers as well. We have a small twin Cessnas, single engine Cessnas, a small charter flights that you can charter from Sulindipendan Airport, or you can fly from not you can fly from the general public part of the airport from Nassau, Bahamas, on Bahamas Air, or Western Air, or some other private airlines into the island of Exuma. And then travel to Little Exuma by car. Take the little bridge. Okay? You can fly into Nassau. You can take the mail boat. Or you can enjoy, have the joy of the enjoyment of the local experience. You can fly in or fly directly into Exuma from places like you can connect from any part of the United States, America, or the world into Florida. And you can take an airplane from Florida directly into Exuma. Okay. Don't forget the 10 things. What not to do while vacationing in the Bahamas. It's not just for Nassau. You have been keeping these places. You have always been the one who's been taking necessary precautions. You have been the one who have not been putting yourself in uncompromising positions for yourself and also for the locals. A damn thing, there's one action causing another reaction. You are the one who maintains standard. Again, if you want to join in on this discussion, get to the kitchen table, 470-382-9632. Send me the word, a text with the word conversation, and let's keep this conversation going. Welcome to Eleuthera, sorry, Exuma. Welcome to Exuma, Bahamas. We look forward to having you, and we look forward to you building great, awesome, safe, loving memories of the Bahama Islands. Thank you very much for tuning in. My name is Lawrence Bentout, aka Lolo, for Kitchen Table Talk. I look forward to joining us in our next segment.